Hey everyone. Good to see you all again. I can see some friends who joined us in the last session, and I can see you all again. Hi Asa, hi Wangya, hi Abhishek, hi Mehernosh, good to see you all. Salome, after a long time, good to see you. Awesome, we're gonna have a blast tonight. Hi Monbemo, hi Tenpen. Thank you for joining in. We're just gonna wait a little, okay guys, before we start off so that everyone can join in. Hi Amos, hi Sudhir Meren, good to see you all. Thanks for joining in. Hey, I can see my sister, Deborah, hi. I hope you're all safe out there in the US. Hi Kining Ule, hi Liang Wu. People, we have a very interesting personality today and we're gonna have fun. Thank you, Abhishek. Marcus, hi. Just gonna move my camera a bit so that I can see you all. My face a bit straighter that way. Samuel, hi. Kyo Tung Lo, hi. Okay, we're just gonna take a few more seconds. But welcome everyone, welcome to TAFMA Live Sessions again. And tonight it's no more my best advice, it's called the TAFMA Summit Sessions. I know, Long Shitang, I'm sure we will, and I'm looking forward. Hi, Atsadong, good to see you again. Guys, this is TAFMA Summit Sessions. We have about great six personalities coming every evening at 7 o'clock. So I hope you all can come in and join us. This session is called TAFMA Summit Sessions. And I want to say a very big welcome to everyone again. This is a follow-up of our last TAFMA session called My Best Advice, where we had live conversations with some amazing Naga musicians and professionals from the music industry. And tonight, we are going to embark on a new journey with musical giants from around the world. We are fortunate to have a lineup of very renowned personalities, individuals who have contributed a lot to the music industry, and they are generously willing to share their valuable experiences and stories with us. We have personalities such as Mr. Uday Banegal, a very close friend of Nagaland and a very close friend to Nagas, and of course the frontman of Indus Creed, one of Nagaland's favorite band. And then we have the beautiful and charming Hina Kriplani, the country manager for TuneCore, which is the world's leading music aggregator. On the 5th of June, we shall meet in conversation with Mr. Sandeep Chota, a musical genius, a director, and a producer who will take us through music production. Guys, hang in there, okay? I'm just telling you guys what we need to look forward to. And then this will be followed with a chat with Mr. Radhakrishnan Nair, the publisher of Rolling Stone India and Man's World magazine. And are we ready? And finally, on the last day, we will have an English musician joining us, Mr. James Asher, a world beat artist, a composer, and a producer. And tonight, it is a delight for me to introduce and invite Padma Shri Shri Kailash Kher, the legend himself, to join us. So stay tuned, okay? I'm just going to give you a quick introduction to Mr. Kailash Kher, although I'm sure many of you are already aware and know his story, but I really want to share a few lines on him. When he was a young boy, at the tender age of 13, he moved from Delhi to Bombay in search of something bigger that could enrich and fulfill his soul. He was bold and courageous. Nothing was going to stop him. In spite of his parents' desire for him to follow another path, he knew deep down that he had found his calling, and that was to sing. Tonight we have a passionate musical genius, a Padma Shri recipient, someone whose voice has moved the country and the world and even our little world here in Nagaland. someone who has moved souls and with his voice, someone whom over one phone call with him the other day, and it's the first time I'm talking to him the other day on the phone, he made me feel as if we have known each other for a very long time. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, stay online as I invite none other than Mr. Kailash Kher to join us live and chat with us. Stay online. I'm going to dial him in now, okay? Stay online, guys. I'm just getting him. Let me see. Where are you? Guys, just stay online, okay? I'm trying to find Mr. Kailash Kher. There you go. People, you can send in your questions. Although it's going to be a fun session, I have a lot of questions I want to ask him too, and you can all join in. Hey there.
Hi.
Good to see you.
Hello. Betel, thank you so much for letting me in, first of all. And good evening to everyone, all our viewers right now. I would like to request and ask you, I'm actually trying to shift to the laptop instead of phone. So could you please help me how to check there, like the live page, I think.
But Mr. Kailash ji, if you can, if you're comfortable on the phone, we can see you very clearly. We can hear you very clearly too. Okay. And
all
I think
right.
Instagram might. Let me just check Instagram. You can take your time if you want to. Okay.
No, we are fine. We are fine. I was trying to actually, you know, because the laptop could have. But I'll make it a more beautiful. Let me get a stand there.
Take your time.
So good to see you.
Better. So good to see you too.
Yeah.
You know, you can fix. You know what you can do? You can fix your laptop and sing a song for us.
In the meantime, we'll do that.
Okay. Are you going to stick to your phone?
Yeah, we can start on the phone also.
Okay, Kailash ji, it's such a joy to finally catch you. I hope I get to catch you in live, in person someday.
Yes.
And amidst all the dark and sad news that's surrounding us right now, it's such a delight for me to welcome you and to start this TAFMA Summit sessions with you.
Yes. I'm so excited and I'm so happy to be part of this wonderful session. And thank you. Thank you, the entire team of TAFMA, and thank you the entire team of Teja and all of you and the wonderful fraternity of musicians, beautiful musicians from our beautiful Northeast. And I'm so thrilled to be, you know, here today with you.
Awesome. And you know what? To start off, we need to do a quick rapid fire, okay? Because yes. I think our viewers will enjoy this and I'm going to enjoy this too. Are you ready?
Yeah. Yes, always ready.
How many concerts overall have you completed?
Till now, my career has been almost 14 years. And I have already finished almost 1,200 plus concerts worldwide with my band Kailasa.
Wow, okay. How many languages can you sing in?
I have already finished 25 languages and more than 1,400 songs, all films and non-films.
Fantastic. Do you have any nicknames?
No, I am Kailash Kher since childhood.
At home?
At home also Kailash.
Okay.
Because
what?
That Mount Kailash is there, so it's
okay. That's true. What's your must do before you go on stage? What is your pre-show ritual that you normally do?
I always meditate and I am mostly meditating in my, you know, usual time also. So that's what I do. Wherever I have a concert, I don't party, I don't go out, I don't, you know, do anything else, and that's all. So even the press conference or anything, I try to make it if, you know, someone else can handle it types. Mm.
Mm. Okay. What do you like to watch when you switch on the TV at home? Let's go inside your home now.
Ask me again.
What do you like to watch when you switch on the TV?
Oh, I don't have TV. I don't have, I live here in 3 floors building, you know.
I swear I don't have TV too. It's been 6 years I've not had a TV.
Yeah, I work for TV and I work every day. I come on TV every day, but I don't
you
have
don't
a
need
TV.
A TV. You're fed up of that, no?
No, not
okay,
fed
what's
up.
What's your craziest fan moment?
So many fan moments are there, but hilarious.
Craziest or the most hilarious one, whichever.
Yeah, craziest, I'll tell you. One girl in Kota, Rajasthan, we were performing for 50,000 plus audience. Mm-hmm. And the backstage near my green room, one girl was arguing with the cops, police, that if you will not let me meet Kailash Kher, then I'll cut my veins right here because I have got the blades and all. And I heard that and I intervened and I requested cops to let her in. And I, you know, made her throw that sharp object in her hand. And I was little scared that, oh God, this can be also some madness. So sometimes, you know, it is too crazy.
I mean, she was quite serious, right? I mean, she was going to kill herself.
No, whether it is serious or not, but those fractions of moment and the excitement of, you know, situations sometimes has to be taken care a little carefully.
Thank God you went and took care of that, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, one more.
But this kind of many incidents are there, actually.
I know.
Yes.
I can imagine.
Yes.
Okay, now this is interesting. We're going to do a quick singing rapid fire round.
Go for
it. You're going to sing the first song that comes to your mind, okay?
Yeah.
So what I'm going to ask for is I'm going to ask for a sad song to start with. So any sad song, the first sad song that comes to your mind, a few bars, a few phrases.
Okay. Kaisi hai ye udaasi chhai mere dil. Kaisi gehri hai ye tanhai mere dil.
Thank you. Happy song.
यूं ही चला चल रही, यूं ही चला चल रही, जीवन गाड़ी है समय पहिया, आंसू की नदियां भी हैं, खुशियों की बगिया भी हैं, रास्ता सब तेरा तक है भैया.
थैंक यू. फेस्टिव सॉन्ग
तौबा 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 वे तेरी सूरत माशाअल्लाह वे तेरी सूरत तनु जेड़ा वेले रब ने बनाया मेरे यार दिल धारा दिसे रब दा नजारा उफ तौबा 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 उफ.
थैंक यू. लास्ट वन. रिलीजियस सॉन्ग.
रिलीजियस.
रिलीजियस समथिंग स्पिरिचुअल.
ओके. दूर उस आकाश की गहराइयों में एक नदी से बह रहे हैं आदियोगी, शून्य सन्नाटे टपकते जा रहे हैं, मौन से सब कह रहे हैं आदियोगी, योग के इस पार्श से अब योग में करना है तन मन सांस शाश्वत सनन सननन प्राण गुंजन
घनन घननन उतरे मुझ में आदि योग, उतरे मुझ में आदि योगी।
Thank you so much. I'm sure everyone's enjoying this. We are so privileged and lucky to have you literally do a concert for us today. Okay, let's get into the topic.
Yes.
I have a lot of questions. We'll have questions from our viewers too. But here's one. In one of your interviews at Algebra Conversations with Shoma, you mentioned beautifully how you felt you were a defective piece, a misfit, and you are taking yourself for a trial. And so I want you to share with our viewers tonight, what drove you to take such a bold step to leave Delhi and go to Bombay at such a young age?
I'm actually, in a way, born in Delhi only, because I was born in a suburb of Delhi. And then finally, we shifted to the main city kind of a place in Delhi. But because I was a little adamant child, and I left home in the very tender age, and because of, I was a little bit of, you know, not listening to others. And maybe because of that, I chose that to leave home. And once you leave home, then you see the different side of people, different side of world. You know, generally how you see world when you have a family, when you are settled down, when you are living with, you know, secured atmosphere. Then world is different. But the moment you go into an insecure situation, then you will see the different side of the reality of human and reality of relations, reality of people. So that was the link where, because I had, you know, passion of music, of singing. Although I haven't learned any formally, you know, I haven't gone for any training. But I used to sing because of instinct, because of so much I have listened, you know, many classical musicians. And also I have been grown up with many stalwarts of folk, like my father, my Pitaji. So I was practicing what I had been hearing since my childhood, and because of which, there is a certain kind of music I used to do. I used to perform, I used to sing as a child. But that style of music wasn't fit in any genre, whether it is classical, pop, jazz, blues, hard rock. You know, in any category, it doesn't fit. So because it doesn't fit, that's why it was confusing. And most of the people in Delhi used to guide me, not like a guidance. So they used to confuse me, saying that your voice is not correct. And this kind of singing is not a singing. This kind of compositions are not good. Don't sing these kind of music. So I was like, wow, man. Those who I trust, I believe that they are music experts. If they are only telling me not to do this kind of, and I am feeling so beautiful after singing these things, and they are spiritual, basically, spiritual composition, spiritual content, spiritual thoughts. So, you know, because of that journey, when you want to achieve something, but the world around you just, you know, either discourage you or demotivate you, or maybe they don't give up those inspirational words. So that, you know, at that tender age, you don't need anything much. You need mostly, you know, some motivational words so that you feel like, wow, I can do it. You know, if your confidence is broken at that growing age, you know, it takes so much time to actually grow that confidence once again. Bethel.
Interesting. So that's how it led you to, you know, so how did Sufi come into the picture?
So then since childhood, I used to sing this. I never knew what is it called. So people used to ask me, what do you sing? Do you sing classical? I used to say no. Do you sing ghazal? I used to say no. Do you sing bhajan? No. Do you sing jazz? No.
Do you sing pop? No. So what do you sing? And then I used to say, no, I don't know what is it called. When I came at the age of almost 30, okay, then I came to Mumbai after going through so much of hardships and all kind of experiences in my life. Then I came to Mumbai to make an album of the kind of music I used to sing, I used to make, I used to write since my childhood. And so many times my confidence, you know, broke, my confidence came back. You know, all the ups and downs I have seen on life. Then I came finally and I thought of whatever it is, let me take a chance. Let me make an album. Let me go to a record company and let me ask them if they can release it. Maybe, you know, if my kind of music works, then it works for me. And then maybe, you know, if people love it, then it will be bonus. Hmm. Now check this out. So I was struggling in Mumbai to make my album, not for singing in movies. I didn't even know because I...
How old were you then?
30. I told you, almost 29 or 30, around that, in 2002. So because I was struggling to make my album and I was trying to find some musician of, you know, my sensibilities. And I found also Naresh Paresh by that time. But then I didn't have money to put in immediately. So I was going very slow and steady. But in the meantime, somebody heard my voice. And then, you know, Mumbai gave me a miraculous opportunity for singing jingles, some, you know, advertised commercials. So my voice became little bit known now in the fraternity. Once it became little bit known, then, you know, the film songs started pouring in my name and I became playback singer now all of a sudden. So the album part became little backseat, took backseat. Mm-hmm. After 2 years, I won some award for my first film song and I became a household name, a new sensation in the playback industry. So all these things, unexpected, surprise, miraculous, magical thing happened. No plan and no particular race or competition in that. So all that happened naturally to me. Now, the demo I was trying to make for my album became so easy because now I am already named with Reckon. One recognized name I became after Allah Ke Bande. So then Sony Music Company invited me and told that, please, now we are ready to release your album. Then we worked, you know, aggressively on our album, rapid speed. Then I formed a band called Kailasa. And Kailasa means divine. Kailasa had already performed at Hornbill Festival twice. Once we performed and once we came to just attend this thing. And then in 2006, Mr. A.R. Rahman, you know, I invited to release my first album where the first song was Teri Diwani and the album's name was also our band's name only, Kailasa. Thank you.
Awesome. So much, you know, see how time flies. See how time flies when you are speaking something so interesting. I'm going to just go on, okay? We're not going to care about time tonight. So, Kailash ji, I believe you also, I'm going to take you back a little bit, okay? I believe you had a short-term experience as an exporter, which many people would not know. And then you decided that is not good for you. And then you dedicated your life to music. And I know so many people who are in business as well as music and they're dabbling, we know which one to go for. And then there are some are very amazing musicians. I want your tips, your advice, your thoughts on this.
No, I was doing business while I was in Delhi. In my actual youth, I was doing a export. And I was doing pretty good also. Only, you know, when I realized that I am not cut out for this and maybe the business is not made for me, because for business, for doing business, business is a beautiful thing, but sometimes you have to be little cunning, you have to be little clever, sometimes you have to be little shrewd, sometimes you have to lie. So business have, you know, all these dynamics, which I was actually, I saw myself, you know, as a failure in that trade, that I'm not cut out, because I live mostly from my heart, from my emotions, and an emotional person can be fooled easily and can be hurt easily. So I was actually shown the way, the light, by Almighty God in itself. And situation teaches you, situation becomes your teacher. So this one situation happened where I was exporting to Germany, Hamburg, and I used to send handicraft. So old handicrafts from Rajasthan, from various parts of India, and I used to ship them to Hamburg. So, and I was doing pretty good. But in the third year of my trade business, export business, this was the biggest order of my life. I was super excited. I was new. I was super excited. So much young enthusiasm was on the peak. So I used to think that, yes, I'm doing well. Now I can grow well. I can buy my own house. I can buy things. I can buy my own car. All those dreams were also I was weaving. Now the, you know, situation turned around and God showed me different path actually. But when God gives you different path, it doesn't give you so easily. First, it creates a situation so that you are prepared for the next thing and next move. So that's what it happened. My business, my export, this order, the last biggest order got cancelled at because of the custom and excise strike happened here in India. And this was a time-bound fair there, like a trade fair. Like how we have an international trade fair here for 20 days. So same time-bound specific window was there. And we missed that window. So the buyer confirmed canceled order, and they could not receive the freight. So my entire shipment went there, but nobody was there to receive. And the first time I took all the stuff, you know, on debt, because I was excited and I was sure that, yes, I have been doing it. Usually they used to send the advance, and then I used to buy and then keep my margin and give the shipment to the forwarding agent. But then it happened completely, it collapsed. And instead of appreciation letter, she sent me one very angry letter. So, and I was like, she almost abused me. And she abused India also. That is why I'm scared for dealing with Indians, because they don't do things professionally, and they don't value, you know, commitments and all. But I didn't have to say anything, because that's a destiny. But that was the time I was going through so much pathos, so much sadness, and I was hurt, I was disappointed, and so many, you know, emotionally drained, professionally drained. So you are completely lost. And that time, you know, because I have been singing since my childhood anyway. So at that time, I thought that even though if I don't make money, at least let me make life worth, life livable. And that is only if I am doing in music. Because when I sing, I smile. And when I smile, I see people smile around me. So I decided that I am going to only sing. That's what I can do best. No manipulation, no cunningness, no shrewdness, no mind games. So better to sing and let others also sing along with you.
Live in peace.
Yes.
You know, but whatever happens, happens for a good. And so I shouldn't be smiling and laughing when you're telling me all the losses in business, but it happened because there was a reason, there was a destiny for you.
Yes.
And we are so blessed because your business failed. At the end of the day, we are the ones who are so blessed. Okay. I first saw you performing when you came to Nagaland a few years back. And of course, I was blown away like everybody else at night. And then I believe you came back a few times again. What's your takeaway from Nagaland?
I love Nagaland people, Nagaland culture, Nagaland people's, you know, attachment towards art and culture and heritage and history of our land. And they are kind people. They are humble people. They are well educated. They know about everything, literature, art and craft, and keeping the ecological way of life, you know, how they want the nature to be intact the way it is. You know, in Nagaland, even the richest people also live with very minimum cutting trees. They don't cut trees too much. They live with nature. So that's what I love the most. And people who live with nature, their nature is good. They're very kind. They're very sensitive. So that's what I love about. And it's not just Nagaland. It's the entire Northeast. They value life. They value all the values, human values. They value all the ethics. And they value each and every achievement, whatever God has given them. So that's what I love about. And the music is what? Music is also a reflection of your personality only. Because when you are happy, you will sing some thoughts of happiness. When you are in joy, you know, when you are dancing within, so definitely it will show from your, you know, lights, from your eyes, that yes, he's in the entire bliss. So it's like that. I see that.
Kailashji, you really should come and you know, live half of your 365 days, half of it, please live in Nagaland. Make a home here.
You know, I wish that happens. Only thing is, I always just see and visualize and smile that God has given me everything, but now time is the only concern. Time God has taken, that time will be mine. But rest, all you have, all the love, all the affection, all the attention of all people and appreciation of my music. Everyone, you know, loves me all around the world. But wherever the most beautiful places where I see, oh God, God, give me at least 2 days to be here. You know, only 2 hours. The most heavenly places also, 2 hours, 3 hours. You know, people make plans for me. Like, wow, Kailash Kher is coming, so we will provide him presidential suite. And you know, the suite where PM Narendra Modi stayed, we will provide that only. So it is like a private cottage and this and that. Oh God, I went there, only God gave me 2 hours. mere Malik, sone bhi nahi diya itna. वो लोग बेचारे कब से होटल सजा रहे हैं, अपना कॉटेज बना रहे हैं, फ्लावर्स सजा रहे हैं, एंड सो मेनी डेकोरेशंस गोइंग ऑन
जस्ट फॉर 2 hours. ओके, यू हैव अ डीप डिजायर एंड लॉन्गिंग फॉर कोलैबोरेशन ऑफ द आर्ट एंड म्यूजिक अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. Nagaland म्यूजिक एंड कल्चर इज रिच एंड यूनिक इन इट्स ओन वे. आई नो कोलैबोरेशन इज वेरी क्लोज टू योर हार्ट. हाउ डू यू सजेस्ट वी शुड शोकेस आवर म्यूजिक टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड?
See, to the rest of the world, before we go to the world, first we should explore, you know, our internal cultural exchange. We should collaborate with the, you know, people, this side and Northeast. And this will create some magic and miracle. I see that happening. I see that potential because I know many of musicians from that side. And I see, you know, the hunger in them, that yes. But only thing is, when we talk about mainland music, it is not only Bollywood or that film music. It is the music as a whole. The entire India has a different kind of flavors in music also. So if Northeast musicians come and collaborate, suppose with a Rajasthani or with a Punjabi or with a Gujarati or with a person who sings in mostly these languages, who's like a, you know, multi languages and multicultural performer, maybe, you know, it will create a buzz that yes, it's a beautiful thing. And this is the time, actually. Right now, the sensibilities of all the governments are also in favor to the art and culture also. Earlier, it wasn't much. Earlier, art and culture was just a part of entertainment. Now, it's a part of therapy. It's a part of healing. It's a part of, you know, in Corona time, in this lockdown time, our Prime Minister has just given a very beautiful statement. I just read today. Mm-hmm. He's saying that along with the doctors, how the doctors are healing the entire nation, the musicians are healing the entire nation as well. Because all the pathos, all the depressions, all the, you know, uncertainties and the darkness in their mind, you know, how music and musicians are healing them and giving them hope.
That's a beautiful statement. Just came up today, huh?
Yes. So if we collaborate within our culture, then we become more stronger. Then once we become more stronger, then we can go globally also. And, you know, because reaching out to the globe, it's not so difficult thing. Because in India, we are 1/6 of the entire world as it is. So if we reach out to every possible evolved music lover within the country, you see, you know, so many connects we have within India. Like, yes, now I want to take this act to New York. Suppose now I want to take this act to LA. And then sky is the limit. Then, so what we are only lacking right now, we are not exploring the world around us, which is so beautiful and so happening. Like if I imagine, if I see, if I collaborate with Alobo Naga or you or Theja or suppose some few more musicians from Nagaland or maybe our Ruben from Manipur. So if we collaborate and soulmate singer. So if we collaborate and we make some, suppose, you know, maybe a song or an anthem for Nagaland or a anthem for a world peace. So maybe, you know, that becomes beautiful thing and we can promote it well. Then we can invite a musician from abroad as well to collaborate. So it's like this, you know, first we have to be more, you know, closely knit amongst each other and more association and collaborations has to happen.
So we have our first project to do. Start working on a piece of music, start sharing. You know, that's one way of collaboration. I mean, working on coming to each other and bringing it to the rest of the country. What else? I'm just thinking as I talk to you, you know, how much do you think we are not doing enough as Naga musicians or Northeast musicians? What can we do better? What can we do more from a perspective of somebody sitting in Bombay? And, you know, I mean, you're a sensation to the world and you know us, you know Nagas, you know Northeast. How do you think we can do better, you know, as musicians? What can we do better?
Yes, as a musicians, we should actually explore more avenues now. You know, let's not just limit ourselves to one place or one style or one part of the, you know, nation. We should explore ourselves, be a traveler, be, you know, explore yourself, spread your wings, you know, and maybe, you know, go beyond some limits, push your limits, go beyond barriers. You know, India is huge. Maybe I see the youth, a musician, you know, from Nagaland, from Northeast, travel to Himalaya and you know make their own music along with some saints or some maybe spiritual practice people. You know, Beatles came to Rishikesh, Himalaya, and they lived with some saint and they explored some spiritual sounds, and it's nothing to do religious, it's to spiritual is nature, and nature is the almighty ultimate. And you know, those things we should explore, we should not limit ourselves. And once we do, once we go beyond limits, then we become limitless. And once we become limitless, then we are limited addition. Because hardly, you know.
People, I need to quote unquote that, okay?
Yeah, rarely people can do that. Everyone wants to be safe. Everyone wants to play in their own cocoon. Everyone wants to be secured in their own boundaries. That's where we, our youth, especially youth from Nagaland, musicians from Nagaland, they have to explore. They have to learn languages, local languages, few Indian languages, as well as they should try to do, to surprise people actually. That's what if I was from Nagaland, let me put it this way, then I would go to Rajasthan for 1 month. And then I would sing some Marwadi song and surprise people that, oh, what is this guy doing? If I was from Nagaland, I would go to, you know, Himalaya for 1 month and do some mad things, you know, spiritually. If I was from Nagaland, I would, you know, I'm thinking this way, that I would go to Punjab and then sing some Punjabi song. Because, you know, human have that power. God has given that light that you can transform anything into anything. You can, you know, turn things into, how we call it, transmutation into the matter. You know, from nothing to something. Human has that power. We have that power to learn, to adapt something new. And we can learn languages so easily. Also, if we adapt, if we try to attempt, you know, some new thing, God also helps. You know, I have observed these things. Like when I was in 2 days, I was in Dimapur and Kohima, I learned few things in Nagamese.
Do you remember?
I remember.
Try it.
Mo Nagamese bhalo lagche.
You almost got it, but it's beautiful. You still got it. you put a mix of Assamese and Nagamese, but it's very nice.
Yeah.
So it's beautiful. I mean, what fantastic ideas you're already, you know, creating and making us burn within inside.
Explore with ourselves.
Yeah.
The musicians actually belong to everywhere. We are not stuck to, we can be born anywhere, any part of the world, but we belong to the entire universe. Music and musicians fraternity is one family basically.
I
keep telling all my friends from everywhere, any parts of the world, that guys, just come to the heaven on earth, you know, explore Himalaya, explore all the hills, explore Northeast. But Northeast, I cannot tell to Northeast musicians because they belong to that anyway.
Yes.
They should, you know, cross over.
Come out.
Yes.
Really, really, really so wonderful. Oh gosh, I have so many questions left and we're like, time is flying.
Yeah, it's
thank
okay.
You. Listen, let's go on till midnight, okay? I have a few questions. Kailashji, I understand you're not a trained singer, but purely, for me, I believe you're purely a gift from above, okay? When you sing, you move souls, and I know everybody feels that way. Have you ever doubted yourself you don't have a good voice, or someone telling you you can't sing, you know, when you were young? I want you to share with our viewers today about your hilarious and delightful story about that, you know, the call you got when you were asked to come to Mahalakshmi famous studio to do a jingle. Can you please share with the viewers this story? And then tell us how you were told.
So I never knew the culture of Mumbai. I never faced a mic in the studio till date. And all of a sudden, I got a phone call in Mumbai. And they asked me that, are you Kailash Kher? Yes. Are you in Mumbai? Yes. So will you come to Mahalakshmi studio, famous studio tomorrow at 3 o'clock? So I kept saying yes, yes, yes. Although I didn't even know where Mahalakshmi, where famous studio, nothing. So then I kept, you know, saying yes, yes, yes to their every questions. And then they asked me that we want to try your voice for a jingle. So I asked, what is jingle? So they told me that ad commercials. Kabhi gaya nahi hai kya? To maine bola, aise bol ke, na haa kiya, na kiya. So still they didn't ask any further questions. So they asked that, okay, see you tomorrow. So okay. I told them, okay, I'll come. So then I found out about the place and things. I went there. So I went to the studio. La Music was the studio's name. Okay. So I went there. There was a film where Aishwarya Roy was there in the film. It was an ad of Nakshatra Diamond. They didn't teach me anything. They asked me, go to the mic, dubbing room. And they asked me, okay, sing something. So I was zapped that, what is it, man? I heard, you know, people teach you, people make you rehearse so much. And then they make you record and all. But today, I have been grown up on challenges like this. I never got anything particular. So this was another challenge. So I thought, okay, maybe, you know, they are just kidding and maybe they are just passing time. And I am also just one spot for them. So cool. So whatever I felt at that time, I sang, you know, without getting into any logics, technical or intelligence, nothing. So I started singing. Tanadum tanum tanana tanadarana tanadum tanum tanana tanadarana tanadum tanum tanum tanadarana tanadum tanum tanum. So I did that and they asked me, no expressions from inside the control room. They asked me, come out.
Just like that, come out.
Yeah, come out. So I thought, no, it didn't work. And it might be funny. And now better to, instead of seeing them and showing my face to them and making them more annoyed, let me go out from the, you know, dubbing room only, from the gallery. But somebody was, as it is, out there in the gallery and he opened the gate of control room. Once I went there inside, then everyone got up and, wow, man, what's your name, man? What a voice, what energy, man. Where are you from? This and that. And so much excitement and so much enthusiasm, so much love and embrace and things. So that's how it happened. And then they gave me so much hope. That
I love this moment. Yeah. Sorry, I kept breaking you. I'm saying I love this story and thank you for sharing with us. Kailashi, you know, it's 7:49. Instagram Live cuts us off at 1 hour sharp, okay? So what I'm going to do is, because there's more and there are questions coming in, do you have time to give us some more? Do you have some more time to share with us?
Maybe by 8:10, because I can delay 10 minutes. 8 o'clock, I have something now. So maybe I can push it till 8:10. So maybe 20 minutes more, we can pull.
Fantastic. So at 8 o'clock, when we cut off, viewers, to all our friends online, at 8 o'clock, we're going to stop our conversation. At 8 and a few seconds, I'm going to bring him back. And Kailashji is going to sing for us, okay? And Kailashji, thank you so much for taking time and, you know, doing this, going the extra mile for us. But here's one more question for you. Yes. With COVID-19, let's get into the current scenario. Suddenly our lives changed overnight. We woke up to something new. I mean, live performances, artists, concerts, you know, the logistics crew, the team, everybody has been badly hit, as much as every other industry. What's going on in your mind about all the situation in respect to performance and musicians as a whole? I mean, we're all at home, recording, singing, all that, but nothing is paying us at this point of time, right? I mean, how can we, what's in your mind?
Huh. Bethel, I see life in a very different perspective. My outlook towards life, towards situations, towards all the, you know, challenges, I see very differently everything. And there is a saying in Urdu, I would say, if few people can understand. Nigahe keher ko gulshan nazar aata hai veerana. Nigahe meher. Meher means kindness. Nigahe meher veerane mein gulshan dekh leti. Nigahe keher, you know, when you are full of negativity, everything you can see just negative. Nigahe keher ko gulshan, even the orchard can be, you know, felt like a stupid, useless place. But the kindness, the positivity can see in the most bizarre things, a positivity also. Mm-hmm. Now, see, there is a way. If I see every musician, every artist, every creative person, mostly are very close to Almighty God. They are more favorite kids of God's. Whoever is into literature, art, any creative field, okay, they are more close to Paramatma, Ishwar, God Almighty. Now, if they are along with the entire humanity, if they are also affected and hit by this pandemic and the worldwide, you know, danger, by changing the entire dynamics of life. If there is one door shut for any people, you know, nature has its way, the 10 doors will open. 10. Comparison is one door shuts, 10 doors open. Only we have to be more aware now. We have to be more sensitive. We have to be more kind within the industry, not only the fraternity of music and music, musicians and art and artists. I'm talking about the entire world, entire humanity. The insensitivity, the inhumanity had grown to another level.
Another level.
So that is why nature, the Almighty God, had to show this. That yes, you have done it extreme now. Please come back. First, be human. Rest of everything will be taken care. You be human first. Because I created you as a human. But don't act like, you know, vultures. Don't act like a ruthless, you know, being. So maybe that is the first challenge. This situation is actually renovating humanity, renovating nature, renovating with reconstructing the sensible and the sensitive soul within us, first of all. Then rest is just a matter of time. You know, maybe after 2 months, some new way of life will happen. Maybe virtual things will take place more. Maybe, you know, things will become more nice. People will become more kind. Maybe they won't be able to earn so much money, but they might earn so much blessings. And, you know, at times in this, you know, so many people are experiencing when they had so much money, but things are not available. They shared with me that, ye mujhe manga do, Kailash ji, main kitna bhi paisa kharch karne ko tayar hun. I can pay any amount. I asked that guy, if you have so much amount, then maybe, you know, you can try to, you know, take a bite in your notes only.
मतलब पैसे ही खा ले चल थोड़े
करेक्ट
इफ यू हैव सो मच मनी बिकॉज़ इवन इफ यू हैव मनी एंड यू डोंट हैव सोल इफ यू डोंट हैव सेंसिटिविटी इफ यू डोंट हैव सेंसिबिलिटी देन डेफिनेटली गॉड विल गिव यू थ्रो मोर चैलेंजेस इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड राइट नाउ इट्स नॉट बिकमिंग एनी पार्शियलिटी और बायस इट्स फॉर एवरीवन सो वेदर anybody poor anybody rich whether anybody small big whatever everyone is responsible to ruin whatever they have ruined now nature is reconstructing itself nature is renovating itself world has become to you know renovation mode and people needs to understand and be cooperative at this time and maybe you know everyone is affected by this and things will change things will change for better but we need to be more kind we need to be more humble and we need to be more human and we need to in this time of challenges we need to be helpful for each other right now this is the lesson behind it
this was needed isn't it
yes this was very much need of the hour actually
Correct.
And God does only whatever is needed.
Kaliji, you know, what I'll do is before Instagram cuts us off, I'm going to log out now and then we'll log in again, okay, right away. So please stay there, okay? Viewers, just give us a few seconds. We'll log back in and then we will continue this discussion. Thank you, Kaliji.